Welcome back to the East Professional YouTube channel. I'm Dr. Barco and today I want to talk to you about how to take good pictures with your dermatoscope. To start off with, I would like to point out basic things that are very relevant to getting great results. First consideration, just make sure that you turn your dermatoscope at its maximum light output. Not all the devices have this option, but if yours does, please remember to set it up correctly. Next item from the checklist is to clean up the dermatoscope by using an alcoholic solution, for instance. You need to make sure that you clean thoroughly both the front and the rear of the dermatoscope lens, and this needs to be done before examining any patient. And the same applies to the lens of the dermatoscope or whatever portable device you are using. The fourth item is also of vital importance. You want to use an adapter that attaches your dermatoscope to the smartphone or tablet and positions the camera in the center of the viewfinder. The fifth recommendation relates to the use of immersion gel or liquid to see in detail the typical structures. However, if you want to preserve certain characteristics such as hyperkeratosis, I suggest you take a previous picture without the gel. One of the most important issues when it comes to getting the best picture is the positioning of the dermatoscope on top of the skin. The faceplate of the magnifying glass should rest completely flat and parallel to the surface of the skin where the lesion is located. In other words, the line that is drawn from the viewfinder to the faceplate of the device must be at 90 degrees to the surface of the skin. In this first example, I produce an exaggerated backwards inclination of the dermatoscope so that we can see in the resulting photo that an inconvenient shadow is produced at the upper portion and also that the area that is in focus gets dramatically reduced to basically just the center of the image. On the other hand, when I intentionally position the dermatoscope tilt forward, the resulting image gets the shadow at the bottom, and again the area in focus is narrowed to the very center. The point number 7 refers to the placement of the lesion that we want to photograph, perfectly centered within the composition of the image, and again with the dermatoscope totally flat and parallel to the axis of the skin. As a result, we get an image where the defocused areas are restricted to just the edges and with no visible shadow. We have to consider that a dermatoscope's lens is basically a magnifying glass, and as such, the edges of the resulting image will always have some distortion and loss of quality. Once all previous things are sorted out, you want to tap the center of the screen of your mobile device so that the autofocus gets engaged and our target appears sharp and well defined. Finally, press the shutter button to take the picture. Another important piece of advice is to firmly hold the camera, especially if you are using a proper camera instead of a mobile device. Whether you take pictures with a compact, mirrorless or reflex camera with the dermatoscope attached, it is likely that the lenses included have a longer focal distance with higher magnification ratios and therefore motion blur is more likely. Use your forearms or elbows to secure your position against the couch or table or whatever surrounding surface you have available and ensure that the gear is held down securely and won't move from the skin underneath. Recommendation number 10 talks about setting up the camera to the semi-automatic mode A or aperture priority mode. In Canon cameras, it is also called AV mode. Finally, you only need to turn the corresponding dial to select a small aperture, such as f8, 11, 13, 16, or even smaller, depending on the camera and the lens. Every now and then I get contacted to ask me about the gear I use for my dermatoscopic images. Before going on, I'd like to point out that I don't have any conflict of interests. I use a Dermlite Foto X as my main dermatoscope, and I attach it to an iPhone 8 Plus with the Magneticonnect adapter. When I need higher magnification or larger files, I connect it to a mirrorless camera from Nikon, to be precise, a Nikon Z50. I routinely take pictures with its kids lens the 16-50mm DX zoom lens that provides with very good quality images. When I want top-notch quality, I use a 40mm macro DX lens from Nikon instead of the zoom lens, and for that you also need the FTZ adapter. I understand that this is a very specialized piece of equipment and not precisely cheap. However, if you'd like to know a bit more about it, do not hesitate and leave your questions in the comment section of this video. Well, that's all for today. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video. Please hit the like button if you liked it and consider subscribing to the channel and forward the link to your colleagues who might be interested. Bye for now and see you soon.